Yo, what's going on, guys? Eric here, aka No Limit Schultz, bringing you guys The Quarry, episode one, part one, whatever you want to call it. I've been dying to play this all night, ever since I got it. And I've been just relaxing for a little while, waiting for my Star Wars part five video to upload. But, without doing too much talking, enjoy.
Alright, well, let's get started.
Okay. Ted Raimi? Is he related to Sam? That? I knew that was Brenda's song, bro. She is in this game. Bro, what the heck? House of Ashes, they have Ashley Tisdale. This game, they have Brenda's song. What's next? They're gonna get Zack and Cody? For a game? First of all, this game, gorgeous. Route 919.
Why'd you kill the music?
I think you know why.
I don't think I do.
Begins with an L? Like the L word?
Lesbians?
Lost, Max. We're lost.
We're in geographic flux.
Right, so lost.
That's debatable.
The heck? Bro, that's so funny.
Take a moment to consider the following, as it will guide you through the various twists and turns that may appear during your stay at Hackett's Quarry. What you see here are quick-time events, or QTVs, which will help you to act at just the right time. Watch your step. Hackett's Quarry can be a dangerous place if you're not paying attention to your surroundings. Take your eye off the ball, and it could spell disaster. The path you tread is to choose.
I'm confused.
But that doesn't mean there won't be obstacles along the way.
There better not be. Bro.
Heads up.
Oh.
Yeah, honey, nice catch.
So wait, is it not with buttons anymore? Is it just the analog stick?
Yeah, and the roads are definitely getting worse out here.
I guess it's all part of the rustic summer camp experience.
Oh, right, that's where we're going. I lost track like 200 miles ago.
200 miles ago, huh?
Yeah. You know what, Max? It's okay. It doesn't make you any less of a man.
You know, if Columbus hadn't gotten lost and landed on these golden shores, there would be no United States of America.
Wrong.
Dogs. See you later, apple pie.
Wrong.
Columbus never actually landed in North America.
What are you talking about?
Didn't even know he wasn't in Asia.
Are you serious?
Just another guy who didn't want to admit he was lost.
Well, just another guy who's got a whole day named after him, so put that in your pipe and smoke.
Oh my God. Okay, just get us to camp already before I roll my eyes out of my head, please.
I'm working on it. I'm working on it.
the hell? I don't even know what a left lead is, so I'm going to map.
Voila!
What is that?
Yeah.
No, but seriously, what happened to the normal map?
This is the normal map.
The one on the phone.
No,
of course. Of course not.
So we are.
What is that weird ass noise?
Have you seen any signs for it? Hey, eyes on the road!
Whoa!
What the heck was that? What? Oh no. Oh. So were those noises that bitch in the back? Cause if so, that was not fucking cool.
Yeah, I mean, still in one piece.
Jesus Christ, what do you think that was? A bear?
What? No, Max, it wasn't.
It was my third leg. I'm sorry.
It was a person.
Oh, are you serious? Do you think we hit a person?
I don't know. I mean, it was really close, like really close, but maybe we didn't.
Okay, so it's just analog stick for the QTEs. Seems like they didn't do actual buttons.
What is it?
I really have this car off.
Well, maybe it looks worse than it is?
I should check out the damage before we try to start it up again, huh? Could you grab my, the toolbox from the trunk?
Yeah, okay.
Ooh, this shit is so eerie.
It's not so bad.
My mom's gonna kill me.
Not real supportive, didn't even say shit. Interrupts.
At certain times throughout the night, opportunities will present themselves, giving you the chance to take matters into your own hands. It is worth noting that they are only suggestions. You don't have to act upon them. In fact, sometimes it's better not to.
Okay. That's sort of why I'm glad I never went for applying to colleges in high school. That would have shot my confidence down.
Perfect, thank you.
I know you get declined from a lot of schools, but still.
Yourself curling up in front of a big old fire pit singing campfire sing-alongs.
I don't think people curl up right in front of big old fire pits.
Why not?
They don't want to catch on fire. Well, anywhere's better than here.
Is there? Excuse me? No.
Just over here?
Don't.
Just.
No.
Stay there for a second, okay? I'm almost done.
Max, hurry up!
What's going on?
I'm worried that there's somebody down there.
Are you serious?
Yeah, they could be hurt. I don't know.
I didn't think we actually hit anything.
Well, I don't know. I heard something, okay? Like a woman.
Do you think we hit her?
I just want to check it out.
Okay.
Mm-mm.
All right.
Mm-mm.
Just don't go too far, okay?
Mm-mm. No.
Okay. Good luck with the car.
That looks creepy, how he's just standing like that. Bro, I don't fucking like this. What was that? Tarek! The fool. I wonder who this is. We all know a fool when we see one, don't we? Innocence and freedom, or recklessness and risk-taking. Spontaneity. Hopefully I said that right. Actions without thought, but the consequences to match. Think, and don't get burnt. Alright, that's 1 of 20. Is that another one? What is that? Clue? Freak show flyer. Yeah, I want to see that. Hold on. This is a poster for a traveling sideshow. It looks like it's been here a while. Left forgotten in the woods. Are those burnt marks around the edges? They definitely seem to look like it. Bro, this music is making me... Bro, this is not making it any better. What was that? Hello? Trunk filled with strange devices, that of an escapologist, perhaps. A relic of a traveling show that must have passed through the air. Ooh. Can you not, like, fast walk? There we go. Stop that shit. Right now. I'm not fucking with this right now. Okay, I'm taking it nice and slow. Why would you just stand there? Don't turn the camera like that.
Where are you?
Never say that. Oh shit, it's gonna be QTEs. There we go.
on? Is everything all right?
Holy shit.
Talk to me. What's going on? What's going on?
There's something out there. There was noises all around me.
Honey, honey, take a breath. It's okay. It's the woods. There's a lot of stuff out there. There's animals. It's easy to freak yourself out.
No. Can we just leave, please?
Yeah. Let's go. No? Yes, there we go. Purring like a kid.
Max, come on!
Here we go. We're getting out of here.
Are you kidding me? Max!
Okay, give me a minute.
We've got to go, Max!
All right, you're not helping right now.
I am trying to get us out of here!
All right, enough! Shit, I'm sorry, honey. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
We're okay. We're safe in the car, really. We're gonna be okay.
Jeez!
Oh, fuck! Oh my god, my heart just exploded.
Roll it down.
Hi, officer. How are you doing this evening?
Are either of you injured?
Really, we're fine. We're just a little shaken up.
You folks want to tell me what happened here?
Hackett's quarry is full of twists and turns, unknown paths and unexplored wonders. With each step taken, you tread a path of your own, matched with its very own consequences. There will be moments throughout your stay that show you that the choices you've made, the path you've chosen, could have gone another way. At Hackett's Quarry, there's no such thing as the wrong way. But be warned, some paths are more dangerous than others.
Something jumped out right in front of the car, and we didn't want to hit it, so we swerved, and now here we are.
Something jumped out?
I'm sorry, it was so dark, and it happened so fast, and they were gone.
They? Ma'am, did you hit someone?
No, God, no, of course not. You know, I mean, I don't think so.
Sir? The car running.
Sir?
Is this kind of like the all-time scariest
thing? I don't know, this is my first cop.
I hope I didn't fuck up.
Yeah, I'm not a criminal.
Folks want to tell me just what in the hell you are doing all the way out here this late at night.
We're heading up to Hackett's Quarry summer camp. We're new counselors.
You're one night early.
No, we know. But we figured we'd get in early and scope it out. You know, they know we're coming. We called ahead.
And to be honest, sir, one of us kind of oversold our navigation skills and got us completely lost.
You're not going to make it to Hackett's Quarry. Not tonight. Harbinger Motel. It's the nearest place. You can bunk up there for the night.
Wait, why is there blood on his neck?
I think we're just gonna stick to the plan, sir. I mean, Mr. Hackett knows we're coming and we called ahead.
No, ma'am, you're gonna head to the Harbinger Motel. Do you understand?
Don't fucking look at me like that.
With all due respect, sir, why can't we go to Hackett's Quarry?
Because I told you to go to the motel.
Okay, I just don't understand what the problem...
Ma'am, please step out of the vehicle.
Whoa.
What? Why?
Officer, she didn't do anything.
Ma'am, if you wouldn't mind stepping out of the vehicle, I would just like to show you a route on your map there.
Sure.
Son, remain in the vehicle.
I don't care if he's getting impatient. You think I personally give a fuck? No. If you were wondering. I have zero fucks to give.
Okay. So, we...
Bro, motherfuckers like you are so weird.
Here. Harbinger Motel.
If you lick a pencil before fucking writing...
Right. Okay, and where was Hackett's
Quarry? I just can't trust you.
Well, I'm sure the fine folks at the Harbinger Motel can guide you there first thing in the morning.
I'm pretty sure they will, but I hope they explain the whole Silas thing. Bro, oh my god, you're so creepy.
Harbinger Motel. Stay on the road.
Wait, but what if there's someone out there?
Yeah, I'll have a look. Good night.
Fuck you. This game's gorgeous.
Why is this guy just sitting there?
For real.
That guy was giving me major weirdo vibes.
The dude needed like at least a dozen showers.
Oh my god, I know.
What was up with the thing? Did you see that?
Was it blood?
Nice to meet you.
Alright, let's get back on the road.
Yes. Is he still sitting there?
Woodland encounters for one night, thank you very much.
Agreed. So where's this motel?
Okay, so we're here,
mm-hmm.
And the motel is here.
Okay.
But we're going...
What's there?
Hackett's Quarry.
How'd you do that?
I don't know, kind of tricked him into showing me.
Very slick. Are you sure we shouldn't just get to the motel and just listen to this guy's advice?
Honey, you really want to listen to the advice of some creep-ass cop who told us in the middle of the creep-ass woods to go to some creep-ass hotel?
No, that sounds terrible.
Yeah.
Let's hit the road, shall we?
That's what I thought.
Ma'am?
Oh my god! If he called me ma'am one more time, I was gonna shove that badge up his dick. Seriously, do I look like a man to you? I got like 20 years before I'm a ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
What?
20's... debatable.
Easy.
I mean, I'm kind of into ma'ams.
Oh, oh god. It's me showing some respect. Thank you, ma'am. I appreciate it. I was born and raised. Amen.
You gotta be kidding me. There's nobody here. We drive all the way the fuck out
Max,
here.
Max, can we just look around before we jump to conclusions?
Did you actually even talk to Mr. Hackett, or did you just leave a message?
Well, what's the difference?
This is the difference.
Hello?
I guess he doesn't check his voicemail.
How was I supposed to know that?
Dumb ass
I mean,
mother.
Clearly there's somebody here.
Yeah, or it's just an abandoned car and this is a complete waste
Why
of time.
Would there be an abandoned... Yes.
What a weenie.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
You're just gonna leave me out in the... Bro, fuck you. Oh, God. Pussy.
Is anybody home?
That better not be someone behind me. Excuse me. The fuck do you think you're doing starting to... Bro, if he leaves me, I swear to God. Wait a minute. Uh-uh. I don't like the camera angle. Fuck that. Ain't doing it. It's nice to know.
What doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Right, are you telling me I'm doing all this by my... Okay, wait a minute. I'm gonna go talk to this pussy-ass fuckboy.
Hey, you ready to roll?
Why can't I get in? Whatever, bro. Camera angle switch. Bro, nothing better pop the fuck out, otherwise I'm gonna shit my pants. I'm so on edge right now. Fuck that. They're in there for a reason.
Max, get over here.
What's going on?
There's somebody in the bunker. I think they might be stuck.
Stuck? Is it Mr. Hackett?
I don't know. Just bring some tools so we can break the law.
Do we really want to do it?
We're going to get you out of there.
I don't think I want to do it.
Hey.
That part black in me is kicking in right now.
Why didn't you just bring...
And I'm dead serious, I'm mixed, so don't even fucking come at me in the comments.
I'm not seeing it.
Look.
I'm looking, I am.
Bro, no. Some shit's gonna pop out, bro.
There was definitely someone there.
Okay, so...
Wrench?
You sure?
Try not to make a lot of noise? Oh, hell no. Hammer time.
Ah! Stupid ass!
Wow, that was super loud.
That's why I was gonna go with the... You know, the wrench, but... I just wasn't too confident in it. And I saw Hammer Time, I was like, oh shit. Oh lord.
You've seen the Evil Dead, right?
Hello? Are you hurt?
You exist?
Do you exist?
Hey, be careful.
I don't like how... You better be right behind me. Ian? Bro, I do not like these footsteps. I swear to God, I just saw a fucking hand. What is this? This bloody collar looks to be too big for a dog. What kind of dog would be called Ian anyway? Dang, there's all types. The fuck is that?
Max?
Max? I need to turn around.
Hun, maybe it was a possum or something.
No, there was someone here, I swear.
Hey, it's been kind of a night, you know? Let's just get to the motel. We can come back here first thing in the morning. We can check everything out, but... I mean, you must be exhausted. I know I am. I think our imagination...
Oh my fuck. Oh my God. Oh fuck. Bro. Oh. Bro, that's the first jump scare? I'm fucked. Oh my God, dude. My heart just fucking went to my ass. Oh, fuck. Go away. I'm gonna help him. I ain't leaving you. We in this shit together. If I die, you die. I'm helping you. Fuck that shit. I ain't leaving you. Baby, we in this shit together. Boo boo. If that thing wanna come back for smoke, so be it. Just kill Max?
Does this look like the goddamn Harbinger Motel to you?
Did I kill Max already? There's no way, right?
I really hope he isn't dead. What is this?
Hello, my friend.
Oh, hi.
Welcome to the show. We are friends, aren't we?
Yes.
I've waited for you. I've waited. Yes. So I do hope our time.
Okay, damn, back the fuck up.
Enlightening.
I don't want to be close enough to smell your breath.
There's no need to worry. I'm here to help you. Think of me as your guide into the unknown. It's exciting, yes. And terrifying. But
bro, do some stupid shit and your face transforms and you jump scare me, bitch. I'm punching a hole through my monitor.
I can help you. We can help each other. This is the card you found.
Mm-hmm.
The fool. I wonder who this is. We all know a fool when we see one, don't we? Innocence and freedom. Or recklessness and risk-taking. Spontaneity. Actions without thought, but the consequences to match. Think. Think, and don't get burnt. I can show you more if you'd like me to.
Yes, please.
This is what might come to pass. A possible future. A path yet unchosen.
Oh my god, this is so cool.
There are secrets out there, you know. Secrets and lies. Paths to uncover on which I can shed light.
Mm-hmm.
If you let me. Help me help you. And remember, what doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
All right. Prologue, okay. Done with the prologue. Hackett's Quarry Forever. Chapter 1. She looked like Padme.
Hearts are broken on the last day of summer camp. It's like a romance apocalypse.
Well, and you never know. The universe has a kind of way of working these things out.
The universe?
Yeah, like the cosmic space gods.
Space gods.
You heard me?
Okay, spell it.
Nothing to spell. You know, we're cool.
Oh, so cool.
We are super cool.
So she dumped her ass.
Boy.
Quit.
Hi, Emma. Hey.
Okay, this is, you've heard of spatial awareness before,
yeah,
right?
Spatial awareness is for nerds. Beat a lamb and grab the last couple of bags, will you?
Yes, boss.
Say hi to Emma for me.
You're a bad person.
Yes, I am.
Alright, I don't know who I'm playing as right now. I don't know his name. Who's that fella? Walk a little faster.
Hey, what are you listening to? Good to know.
Jake, bags, focus.
What do you think I'm here for? Sharkeesha? Yell at me. Go upstairs. Alright, sassy pants, fucking shit. Somebody hasn't had their fucking weekly dick appointment.
Jesus Christ. Hey, are you guys gonna help with the bags or what?
Oh, you know, I was actually just working on fixing the door. It's...
Dylan, come
it's
on.
Broken.
Dylan, please.
I can't. It's.
I gotta get the last bags in there. Come on.
What's wrong with this thing? It's just
Dylan,
broken.
Please.
Sorry, guys.
Cool. Thanks.
They're fucking. Hey, bitch. Open up.
Dipshits bolted it. Really?
Hmm. Hackett's quarry. Hackett's quarry summer camp was established way back in 1953 and is still going strong today. Nearly 70 years.
Skill. Oh, double skill.
Wait, what the fuck? If he would have said triple skill or some shit, I would have fucking died. Alright.
Ugh. Horror. Hate horror.
That sucks. You're in a horror game, buddy. Got your ass. Game is gorgeous.
This needs a serious overhaul. Hello. Jesus. Okay, really, dude? Locking me out?
Okay, in my defense, A, it was Dylan's idea, and... Two, it was really funny.
Oh, yeah, right. Is that right?
I don't mind the rules, man.
Okay, whatever. Look, are you gonna help me with the bags or what?
Nah, I gotta stay here and wait for Mr. H to return our cell phone. Sorry.
Jesus Christ. Okay, and why are the stairs blocked?
Well, apparently it's to keep raccoons and other pesky varmints from ransacking the place. Mr. H's words, not mine.
Oh! Boring! Is that you, Dylan?
I can only deal with one shit at a time, Jacob.
Can I piss him off? All right, fuck it. So pretty. This fucker sitting on the staircase. Dude's fucking taking a shit. I was about to say, did he finally leave the room? What am I missing? I mean, it is a big ass cabin, so I probably missed a lot of shit in here. Got the bags.
Great. All by yourself, huh?
Yep.
Guess you're gonna have to get used to that.
Oh my god, you are so mean.
At least I'm honest.
Oh, okay, here we go.
Okay, you're not telling me the whole truth about you and Emma, are you, son?
Oh, okay, so now I'm the one who's not telling the whole story, huh?
Oh, well, this is the bait I just gotta take, Jake. Oh, sorry, I just got so distracted about that rhyme, I forgot what we were...
Oh, no. You were telling me how you totally have a thing for Ryan.
Wait, are we talking about Ryan, the sailing instructor with the sexy brooding loner thing that totally doesn't do anything for me at all?
Ah, sexy, huh?
Hottest sexy, by far.
Okay, sure.
Look, it was all settled by the girls in bunk 7, like, second day of camp. It goes Ryan, me, of course, then Dylan, Emma, Abby.
Okay.
Nick, and then Mr. H, and...
Okay, are you almost finished, please?
Yep, that's it. That's everyone.
Ouch.
So she really just dumped her ass, huh?
I don't... Okay. Her whole thing is like, how are we gonna make this work? Different schools, blah, blah, blah. My whole thing is like, you know... Maybe long distance, blah, 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 blah. And she was just like, Jacob.
She gave you the look, huh?
Yeah, do not pass go.
Man, she just got you wrapped all the way around that dainty little finger of hers. How does she do it?
No, but I mean, seriously, come on, she's right. It's just like a stupid summer fling. What else did I think was going to happen?
Let's see. Love, stability, engagement, marriage, house, kid, affair, kid, divorce, loneliness, child support, visitation lawsuit, surprise reconciliation, emptiness, retirement, grandkid, nursing home, and finally, dying in each other's arms and then being buried in each other's arms like those 1,000-year-old skeletons they dug up in Rome or something. That kind of in the ballpark? Oh, shit, I'm sorry. That was Ryan and me. Let me see. Ah, here it is. Yours just says Roadhead. Oh, actually, that's just a generic all-men list.
Well, that seems legit. So, are we sure that this old rust bucket's Roadhead?
Damn.
We'll take a look. It better be. One more night in the great outdoors might actually kill me.
Hey, it doesn't kill you. It'll make you stronger.
Well, I haven't killed you. Yet. You're still pretty pathetic.
Hey, shut up.
Why the fuck did she say that?
Okay, so,
I have my eyes on her.
Hypothetical, but if I was, like, a huge asshole and I wanted to break down the van so we'd have to spend another night here, what exactly would I need to do?
Well, you'd probably break the fuel line or, I don't know, rip out the rotor arm. And yes, that would make you a total asshole.
Okay, and what does a rotor arm look like again?
It's like a arm that's all rotary. You know, it's under the little black dome with the leads poking out. Jake, you do realize that even if we somehow did get stuck out here, one more night with Emma wouldn't make a difference. Trust me, Chick's made up her mind.
Yeah. Sure. I guess we'll just have to find out.
I'm not doing either. Can you decide not to do either? I don't know.
Why did they look like they're up to something?
Hey, Jacob.
What? No, dude, please. Don't.
Go along.
Oh, Nick.
Oh, God, I'm like Randy Moss.
Oh, there it is.
Oh,
ooh.
Man, good sight.
Freak.
Oh. Ooh, I wish I had some singles.
Ooh. Freaks. I'm surrounded by freaks. Oh, thank God. I'm gonna get the whole new technology thing, but take me back, world.
You would have thought Mr. H could have, like, charged up our phones, like, a little bit.
Nothing's ever your fault, is it?
You know, you should really just save it for emergencies only. Unless, of course, is being dumped an emergency.
Damn, oh, why is everybody on my man's dick? Oh God, at least I get some.
Well, at least I had a relationship this summer.
Ooh, damn, now we burn.
Yeah, well, maybe not everyone is looking for a hookup.
Okay, let's all put our little dicks away and get the show on the road, huh?
Where's everybody else?
Why would I know that?
Sometimes you know stuff I don't.
Look, I don't even know how to respond to that.
You say, Nick, you're way smarter than me, and you're a super hot stud who gets any cheeky wins.
Okay, yeah, keep dreaming, Junior.
Boy, please. Abigail. I wonder who her actor is. She already looks familiar.
Hey there, party bear.
Status report?
We are officially empty nesters. High five up top.
Up top.
Oh boy, you're about to get your phone back, aren't you?
Let's go collect our bags and away from this mosquito-infested backwoods dump.
Door's locked, bags inside.
Fuck me.
Yep.
Well, it's obvious what we have to do here.
Find someone with a key?
Shape our destiny. And by shape our destiny, I mean shape our way through this crappy lock and grab our bags.
Shit, I'm breaking in.
Okay, let's do it. We better not get in trouble.
I won't tell if you won't tell.
Mr. Hackett's gonna find out.
So what? He'll just think it was a bear or something.
Have you ever seen a bear in these woods?
No, but that doesn't mean they're not out there.
Fair point.
All right, let's do this. On three. One, two, three! Ugh. All about the power of positive thinking.
Why do I ever listen to you?
Because I'm always right.
Are you sure they're gonna think it was a bear?
Oh. My God, relax. It's not like we killed someone.
All right, well, I'm just gonna take another look around, make sure we didn't miss anything.
Go nuts. was little Izzy's.
I can't even see what it is.
I want to play a game.
Oh, hell no. Nope. No, thank you. I'm leaving that bitch. I ain't fucking with that shit.
Yeah, you'll probably just stay here, you creepy little thing.
Mm-mm. I ain't fucking with that shit. Not how I roll, brother.
I can't believe I'm actually gonna miss all those lumpy, loose springs.
Bro, turn around. Go to the other side.
Why would this place be in the news?
Where did she go? Aw, that would be cool if you could sit on the swing.
Ouch. So Jacob hasn't seen this. Ready to roll? Let's do it. Finally. Time to let loose and vamoose this caboose. How are you so dramatic?
Annoying. Confident.
It's just acting. It's what the people want.
So you're faking it?
I mean, in a way, faking it is just being yourself, but louder. You should try it sometime. You never know, we might impress.
Nah. It's too late now anyway.
For what? You and Nick? You never know unless you put yourself out there.
Myself out there. What if he ends up being a dud, kind of like you and Jacob?
It's actually really sweet.
Then why'd you quit it?
Summer fling. We're going to school like 4 states away. He gets it.
Yeah, sure.
But that's us. You and Nick could be different. When do you get his handle? Hit him up.
Oh, I already have his email. It was in the packet they gave to us on the first day.
Email? Are you 93?
What's wrong with email?
I'm really gonna miss you, Abby.
Oh, hold up! Oh, but the lodge is that way.
Go right here.
Why?
Come on, scenic route? One last victory lap around the camp?
I'm playing it safe because I fucked up earlier by not playing it safe.
We should really get back.
Boo. Thumbs down.
Everyone's waiting for us.
Nick isn't gonna leave without saying goodbye.
Shit, Abby! Too close.
Sorry, squirrel dude. My girl here is on her way to ask a guy out for the first time, like, ever.
Emma!
Let her squirrel out of it.
I am going to throw you out of the cart.
I deserve that.
Dylan.
Don't worry, Jacob. I got you. I got a full tank of gas, so... Oh, fuck me.
Oh, idiot.
Does nobody have phone chargers anymore?
There's no signal out here anyways, dude, okay? This place is like patchy as balls.
Your balls are patchy?
What? No.
It's okay, I'll just go get some juice from Mr. H before we go.
Ew. Hey, Nick.
Hey, where were you guys?
Wouldn't you like to know? Ignore her, please.
Let's go. Just gotta get these bags up onto the...
Oh, hey, here, let me get it for you.
I can take care of my own bag, thank you.
Are you sure? Because, I mean, it's really not that big of a deal.
She can take care of her own bag, thank you. We can both take care of our own bag, thank you.
Fucking bitch.
Cool.
I don't like her. I don't care if you break your elbow.
Abby, do you need...
Yeah.
Can I...
Thank you.
Wingman of the year.
Hey, has anyone seen Ryan?
Oh yeah, he's probably off being all brooding and mysterious and alluring somewhere.
I'm here.
What were you doing under there? Having a little knee party?
I was listening to a podcast, actually.
Oh, podcast. Nice, that's cool.
What's it about?
Is it about me? What?
Yeah, what's it about? Is it about me?
You think I was listening to a podcast about you?
Okay, if anyone here had a podcast about them, it'd be me.
Yeah, if there was a podcast called How to Look and Smell Like a Butt.
Oh my god, you are so childish.
Really, so look and smell like a butt.
No, it's a paranormal podcast. This episode was actually about this place, really enough. The Hack of Hackett's Quarry.
The who of the what's it where now? What's the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
You don't know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
If I did, would I be asking them as?
Tell her about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
I don't think she wants to know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Can we just please stop saying the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
It's just this campfire story for the kids. It's, there's supposedly an old woman who died in a fire a few years back. She haunts the woods looking for her lost baby boy. There are, like, reports of whispers or whatever, and this figure that floats around, you know, textbook ghost stuff. Some people say that if she catches you alone, she'll try to turn you into her son. Or kill you, or something. I don't know. It's never really been clear. Anyways, Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
You made that up.
It's right here in the podcast, right?
Cool story, bro.
Oh yeah, you got a cooler one?
Oh no, I wasn't being sarcastic.
I didn't really tell it right.
Look, no, seriously, dude, I think it came out wrong.
You gotta be careful with this stuff, man. This shit's true.
Dude, bullshit.
What's the holdup, Hacketeers?
Yeah, nearly done, Mr. H!
We're up to it. Get those butts in gear.
Sorry, Mr. H.
You had to liberate some luggage.
Shut up. Maybe if somebody didn't spend so much time trying to impress the ladies with all his ghost stories.
You asked.
Ghost stories?
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Oh!
Hey, you still have the van key, Mr. H?
Well, yes, I do. You know, I'd lose my head if it wasn't stuck on. Back to the office I go. Give me a hand, would you, Ryan?
Oh, okay.
Yo, Mr. H.
What's up, DJ Dylan?
Any chance I could get a little charge? I want to have some tunes for the road.
No can do.
Cool, yeah. No worries.
Good man.
No big deal. You can share my earbuds. So,
Ryan.
Chris, I'm actually glad we got a moment to talk.
I'm not fired, am I?
No, it's just, you know, about the whole thing with the...
Of course.
Hold that thought, partner. I'm gonna have to take this.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, sorry.
Hello? Sorry about that, bud. Didn't mean to push you out like that.
You need a hand looking for the keys?
No, end of summer, busy. So, anyway, you were asking me?
Oh, yeah, it was just the whole animation school thing, what you thought I should do.
Right.
Whether or not I should, like, leave my sister with my grandparents, since I'd have to live on campus, you know. My mom's not exactly around, so I wouldn't want to leave Sarah on her own. Our family's small enough as it is.
Well, family is important, Ryan. Dang it.
Is everything okay? You got a hot day tonight?
Oh boy. If you only knew.
So, what did you need me for?
You're one of my favorite counselors, Ryan. You know that. One of the good ones. But, do you know how many calls I get from parents? Letter after letter. These terrified kids that they send home.
I didn't realize that.
Believe it or not, scaring kids away from sleepaway camp is kind of bad for business. So maybe just ease up on the ghost stories.
Sorry, I didn't realize it was such a big deal.
Gotta understand the repercussions of your actions, Buster. It's a big part of being a counselor. Leader.
Yeah.
Just stick to kumbaya next time, okay?
What's that?
You guys don't do kumbaya anymore? Good grief. I'm outgrowing my own cliches.
Seriously, Chris, what's going on?
I just want to get you guys safely out of Dodge before the sun goes down.
Yeah, why?
Why?
It's getting dark, Ryan, and it's not safe to drive in the dark.
Okay.
Safety is the first step towards fun. Just give me a minute. Where in the good goddamn are they?
Will you say goodbye to Caleb and Kaylee for me? He sort of just snuck off.
Well, you'll see him again next year. Caleb works at the scrapyard during the off-season, and Kaylee, well, she's still figuring out what she wants to do. She's got her whole life ahead of her. They both just come and go as they please, really. Teenagers, am I right?
Actually, could have used the help packing up since we were short-staffed.
Hey, you guys seem to manage all right. But I'll tell them both you were sad you missed us. Unlocked the van, put the keys in my pocket, came in the office. Right where I left it. Let's skedaddle. Make sure they're all ready to go. For real this time.
Wait, how did you get your phone back before the rest of us?
I never turned it in.
You shouldn't have turned it off before you handed it in, Dylan. Them's the rules, you noob.
I try not to dwell on the past, man.
Good. Because it's time to dwell in the minivan. Get on with our respective lives. Move it, let's go.
Oh my god. There's no way.
What's the problem?
Ugh. Dude, I don't know. I think there's something wrong with the engine, Mr. H.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, dude, it's just like kaput.
Alright, let me try.
What, dude, I'm telling you. Alright, it's busted.
Well, maybe you're doing it wrong.
Well, maybe you're doing it wrong.
What the fuck, dude?
Enough! Enough, both of you. Shit. Come on.
Alright, dude,
on.
Chill. Chill, dude. Damn it!
I thought I told you kids to check everything.
No, we did. It should be working.
Yeah, well, coulda and shoulda doesn't mean it is, does it? Damn it! Okay. Okay.
Well, look, it's not that big of a deal, okay? We'll just spend one more night here.
No! No! Just stop. Let me think.
Why is he so anxious? Bro, chill.
Okay. Damn it. You're right, yeah.
What?
Yeah, you're right. Hey, Ron. Come here for a sec. Make sure that everybody is inside the lodge for tonight. Lock the doors. No one in, no one out. No one. Got it?
Okay.
I'll be back first thing in the morning. And we'll get you all on the road.
Why are you leaving?
Everyone inside.
The fuck?
Can you promise me you'll do that?
Yeah, for real.
We have to stay inside until tomorrow? Why? Where are you going?
Ryan, I need you to trust me. Like I'm trusting you.
Bruh. Can you do that? You're literally the camp counselor, bro.
Lock the doors. And for God's sake, keep the noise down!
Well, this is where shit goes downhill.
So, what was that about?
He, said to stay inside, that we're not leaving until the morning.
Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? What are we supposed to do?
Well, we should go inside, like he said.
We could go inside until morning.
Yeah.
Or we could do something else.
No. We should really listen to what Chris told us to do.
Of course. Who cares what Chris told us to do? He's not our boss anymore. P A-R-T. Why the fuck not? Alright, it seems like the stars have aligned for us, no?
Okay, okay, okay.
One last epic bonfire blowout for all time.
Oh, dude. Fuck yes, I'm in, Nick. You're in.
Yeah, I'm in.
Dylan's in, obviously. My man. Caitlin?
I go where my people need me.
Yeah, okay. Em, what do you say?
Yeah, I'm in. Mr. Hackett seemed pretty insistent we stay in the lodge.
He's just trying to freak us out, you know? Like one of Ryan's stupid ghost stories.
Why would he want to scare us?
I don't think he was trying to freak us out, Jacob. I think he was really freaked out by something.
Jesus Christ.
Chris seemed real serious about this, guys.
Just say you're in, man. Come on, one last night.
Yeah,
dude, he won't even know.
I promised.
No, dude. It's all good, all right? We get it. You know, you don't want to disappoint Daddy.
Yeah, well, someone's got to give a shit.
Oh.
You know what? I don't even care what you guys do.
Oh.
I'm doing what Chris told me to do.
Ryan, come on, man. Wait.
All right. Hacketeers. Party planning committee. Let's do this. Okay. First things first. Nick and Abby, you will get some firewood. Em and I will go to the stores for some supplies. And, Dylan, you just, I don't know, figure out how to charge the phones or something. All right, let's do this!
What the hell? The fuck? Hunting season? I was like, what the hell does that say? I couldn't read it. Bro, can I just get a part where... I want to end the episode, but they keep doing this.
I was hoping you'd come back to me.
Why are you looking up like that?
Let's see what you found. Empty-handed. You need to look around you, find my cards, and I can help you. Where I'm from, we look out for each other.
Damn, okay, so I'm not looking good enough, huh?
Please.
Alright. I'm sorry. Don't yell at me.
You'd better be going. It's still early and the moon is bright, but time won't wait. Not for those with a story to tell. Be careful. Look out for yourselves.
Will do.
Look out for my cards.
Bro, why do you say it like that? Hey, don't make that angry ass face. Hold on, calm them down. Alright guys, that's been it for part one. I hope you guys enjoyed this game. I love this game. I love it. I can't wait to see the rest of the game play out. I don't really know how long the game is supposed to be. But I will say, I'm enjoying it so far. And then, as of today, technically when I post this video, after I get off of work, me and Donnie should be starting our duo, like our co-op playthrough. But with that being said, that's been it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, drop a like. Subscribe if you're new. Turn post noties on. And yeah, it's been Eric, guys. Peace. This bloody collar looks to be... Oh my god. This bloody collar looks to...